You made it. Come here. Sit with me. So eager. I'm surprised it took you this long. Well, to begin, I think a toast is in order. Any suggestions? Not worried, are you? Rest easy. To not being poisoned. How about that? Now tell me something about yourself. And no tadpoles, dragons, marauding goblins, or anything like that. Something about you. You must have an extraordinary affinity for the darkness. I'm jealous. Don't stop now. Not just as things are getting interesting. Don't laugh, but I'm not quite sure I have anything to share. When you worship Shard, secrecy is everything. We'll sacrifice our own memories when ordered to. A lot of the little things, they're lost to me right now. I did. And you remembered. You're sweet. There's still plenty of wine, and the whole night is ahead of us. Nearly light. The others will be awake soon. What? I know. But you're sweet to notice. Thank you for last night. Me too.
She trails off. You read an invitation in her eyes.
That didn't hurt, did it? I should think so. Let's head back, if we must.
I trust you enjoyed your evening. After all your efforts, it was well deserved. It may be some time before you're afforded another such night. There is much to be done, and I promised I would help you however I could. I'm certain a cure for you can be found at Moonrise Towers, but it's complicated. The journey specifically, it's extremely perilous, though it seems you're well accustomed to navigating danger. To get to the towers, you'll need to pass through a terrible place. A cursed place. This curse shrouds everything in shadow. You will not find life, light, or anything natural there. Any who linger are twisted by the curse. They become shadow beings, tormented, dangerous souls. So it seems, though I don't know how. You'll have to choose your approach carefully. You could go overland, along the Risen Road or through the mountains. Easier at first, but you'll run into the Shadow Curse eventually. You could also go under. There is a tunnel somewhere in the ruined Temple of Saluna. It leads to Moonrise Towers through the Underdark. Long ago, a man called Ketherick Thorm built a secret stronghold deep down there before rallying a whole army of Dark Justiciars, Shah worshippers.
Dark Justiciars? I must see for myself.
Aridan and his lot were looking for a way down there. They were promised riches if they retrieved a relic called the Night Song. But I think there's more. From this stronghold, Ketherick's forces could access both the Temple of Siluna and Moonrise Towers. But he was defeated before he could launch an attack. If you can find this place, I'll wager it will reveal a more direct path to Moonrise Towers. And maybe even bypass the worst of the Shadow Curse. Anything is preferable to risking the Shadow Curse. I would like to join your camp, if you'll allow me. I can offer my skills, my counsel. I've long sought to return to Moonrise Towers. It seems our fates have aligned. You'll need to pick it up where Aridin left off. Find the hidden entrance. It's somewhere in the Temple of Siluna. Unfinished business, and a lifetime of regret to repair. I helped overthrow Ketherick Thorm and his Dark Justiciars years ago, but I failed to prevent him from unleashing darkness across the region before he was defeated. I spent years researching the curse, trying to put an end to it. Nothing has worked. Yet, if I can join you and get close to Moonrise, perhaps I can lift this curse. Same as you may find a cure for your infection. I've chosen a successor as first druid, Francesca of the High Forest. A bird's already been dispatched to summon her. I need her to stay focused on her training. The Grove will need a skilled healer in my absence. The Grove needs to move beyond the mistakes of the past. What it needs is an unknown quantity. An outsider who can enforce the Oak Father's teachings without bias. This is why I chose Francesca. She will restore simplicity and purity to the Grove in my absence. Indeed. We've quite the journey ahead of us.
Wonder if the gods are watching me.
Fate spins along as it should.
Dost thou require a new ally? Or mayhaps a resurrection instead? Very well. Impossible. Thy party is full.
Something's on my mind.
Hey, soldier. Let's hope Damon is as good as he seems. Once my engine's handled, I can focus on more important matters. Tadpoles, cults, frosty pints. I'll tell you all about it after we've taken down those paladins I'm after. Believe me, it's worth the wait. Gives me energy. Power. But you've seen it in action. Very hard to control. If I'm excited at all, angry, nervous, delighted, enticed, I burn hot. Hot enough to burn anyone who gets close. I try not to think about it. I still think about it constantly, but, you know, I try. One of these days, I'll sort the whole infernal affair out, get myself cooled off, start making up for lost time. But not today.
All's well, I hope. was going to say the very same thing. As soon as I worked up my courage a little. I can't recall the last time I shared so much with someone. Maybe I never did before. It meant a lot to me. You mean a lot to me. And that was before the kiss. I hope so too. Though I'm not sure what kind of courtship we'll be afforded, given all that we're facing. But if you want to see where this goes, I do as well. Wouldn't you be in my place? If there's even the slightest chance that Shah worshippers remain within our reach, we should try and find them. Even if they're all long gone, and that seems quite likely from what we know, who knows what they may have left behind for us to use? My people are nothing if not resourceful. As long as I've prayed to Lady Shah, I've wished to serve her as a Dark Justiciar. There is scarcely a greater way to fully dedicate yourself to Lady Shah, save perhaps if you become the head of her church. To become a Dark Justiciar is to become the Night Singer's sword arm, her implement with which she will cast down the unbelievers and win the final battle to restore her perfect, endless darkness. It's all I ever wanted. I prayed it was my calling, but Mother forbid me from seeking to prove myself worthy of the rank. She said I was not ready. Not my mother, I should add. The Mother Superior, head of Lady Shah's enclave in Baldur's Gate. Sometimes I wonder if she would ever deem me ready. I owe her everything, and I only wish to serve, yet she can prove inscrutable. Very serious of you, but go ahead. Always good when I'm with you.
Hello. Quite the cozy setup you have here. I'll just make myself comfortable. Thank you so much. My research turned up a rather brilliant technique that seems quite actionable.
It's not too deep. Just behind the orbital socket. I could attempt an extraction. I've a needle in my tunic, after all. I assure you, I've dreamt of it 1,000 times over.
Volo carefully holds one of your eyes open and begins to prod uncertainly with the needle. The needle finds the gap between eyeball and socket. Volo frowns and begins to push. Pain shoots through your body as the needle snags on your optic nerve.
I think I have it!
The needle seesaws back and forth, plucking the nerve like a harp string.
Oh, bother. There's some obstacle in the way. I shall need a more robust implement.
Volo carefully withdraws the needle from your eye. Then, reaching into his bag, he produces an ice pick. Volo slowly brings the ice pick closer to your eye.
Now, don't move.
Cold metal presses against the skin beneath your brow. And then, tap, tap, stab.
Do you feel that? Ha! I think we have the blighter on the run. I agree. It's a feisty critter. Just a little further.
Volo tears the pick from your brain with a violent jerk. Your eye plops down into the mud.
Drat.
He pauses, looks down at your eye, and recoils slightly as it sinks into the mud.
To be an amount of cosmetic damage. Please, try not to overexert yourself. You're in a rather fragile state at present. I can't help but feel partly responsible. Perhaps there is something more I can do. Take this. A far superior relic to that old jelly you were chained to. Try it on for size. And, it was very nice to have met you. I'm sure you'll sort out your little brain problem one way or another. Far away from here, if you've a heart. Terribly sorry, my friend. Ta.
Father's blessings to you. Wonderfully. If I'm honest, the grove was too comfortable for my tastes. I felt removed from nature. I'll miss my books, but I can find all the wisdom they contain out here firsthand. Is that so? Well, nature does abhor waste. I will keep watch, thank you. I had a feeling time in your company would prove fruitful.
Seems simple enough.
The sun is nice. The tieflings have moved on. We can restore the harmony of the grove now.
Anything of use?
Beast away from us, you hear?
Me, the beast? Now that's fucking rich.
Leave us in peace, and we shall leave you in kind.
Cut the crap, Anders. I know what you are.
Don't let her hurt us. Please. We just want to go home.
Squint of his eye. You suspect he's lying.
Enough! Enough! I'll not play pretend anymore. Karlak, you're going home in pieces if needs must. And you, you'll soon learn what it means to ally yourself with the likes of this garbage.
Avernus was never my home. It was my prison. I'm free now. And I'm never going back!
Heading there.
Let's light them up.
matters.
Yes. Ready for this?
See their chances.
I'm never going back. And if any of Mummy's little friends want to pick up where the others left off, they'll find nothing but a pile of ash. That's right, she won't. She can't. She couldn't even lay a finger!
Another step forward.
Fuck you!
Something good here, I hope.
Johnny!
That ought to do it. Whew. Had to let off a little steam after facing off with those ignots.
Granted, the fire's lasting a little longer than it should. How do I look? Honey, I could go all night.
Engine heats up the whole system enough not to get burned. Hopefully it will hold together long enough to get tuned up. Let's move, huh? I'm running high and in the mood for a fight.
Going a little longer now.
No one stopped me yet. On my way.
I must keep going.
No time to rest. I need to find a way forward.
What's cooking?
Waterdeep.
path less traveled.
Who the hell's... Get over here and help! If we don't deal with them gnolls, none of us are getting out of here alive. Fine. Money's useless to dead men. There. You are fairly bought and paid for. Let's take them!
Still alive, so that's progress. Something over there.
Thank you.
focus straight through.
These mortals be.
It's hot in here.
Let me recite their demise.
Dead talk! Swift as my feet can carry me.
Oh.
that's up for discussion.
Thank the gods that's over. Wish you'd been with us when the beasts attacked on the road. Might have been more survivors. I don't suppose you saw any of my crew alive out there. Damn it. I guess that's a no. Risen Road's more dangerous than ever. You're the first friendly face we've seen since Eltergard. We're bound for Baldur's Gate. Got some cargo to deliver. But we've a stop to make along the way. Thanks, but that won't be necessary. We'll find help at Joaquin's Rest. Listen, you look like you know how to handle yourself. You should meet my associates. We've got our own drinking spot by the tavern. Invitation only. Tell the fellow on the door, Little Serpent, Long Shadow. He'll take good care of you.
Rugen!
It's fine. We'd be dead if they hadn't shown up. A little hospitality won't do any harm. Well, lad, it's our lucky day after all.
I don't feel lucky.
The rest of our crew's half digested, and you're still alive. That's lucky.
One day I'll catch a break. Let's have a look.
Don't burn yourself.
What's inside?
It's been a while since these two breathed their last.
there are harper and druid symbols on their equipment. An interesting pair.
Seems like someone like their books to have a twist.
Or maybe a bit of a drinking problem.
This is my happy place.
Oh,
One moment they were embracing each other in intimacy. The next they're embracing only death. Get my beauty sleep soon. I may just get a tad malcontent.
I'll feel that one later. Best be on my way. Good here, I hope.
Weapon blueprints. The master blacksmith's work.
Not too refined here. Just quick ideas sketched out.
Does. No traps.
Seems like a pack of goblins swarmed the arbor.
She deserves better than that.
The corpse remains silent.
Supposed to be worth a fortune.
It'll take a while for us all to recover, but you've helped us take the first step. Of course. May you keep balance.
From an overgrowth of moss, the well looks unremarkable. Dry stones line the wall. At the bottom, something gleams in the dappled light.
Better be careful. Those webs carry vibrations.
guards in here.
Like that.
What am I to do?
I need more pockets. Looks empty.
shy.
I'm ready. Whatever it takes.
Sousa bark. Rare find. There's only one place I'm finding a Sousa tree. The Underdark. Let's have a look. Can't keep me out.
Someone can use this to fix me. Thank you.
go.
Heavy. Moisture drips down your forehead. Pain shoots through your fingers.
Chukilgake vlaketh mazathok. Can you feel it crawling through you? Tendrils squirming in your chest, gripping your heart, piercing your belly. Your bones popping, your flesh swelling. I can. I see it in you. I feel it in me. We are lost. I will be quick with my blade. First you, then the others, then myself.
Your minds intertwine. You sense a touch of uncertainty, a touch of disgust.
I cannot trust my own mind, so it seems I must trust yours. I will wait, but know this, I am watching. If the sickness does not pass come dawn, I will end us all. I came just in time. You are transforming.
Yes. You have. I saved you before. And I'm here to save you again. Don't worry. You will not become a Mind Flayer. Not while I'm around. I'll protect you. We haven't much time, so listen closely. There is great potential within you. It comes from that parasite. Your instinct is to resist the power it gives, but you must accept it. Nurture it. I will keep it from consuming you, but for the sake of both of us, you must learn to wield it. Fate of Faerun, a fight we are losing. For now. You can change that, but only if you embrace your potential. is closing in. I will be back. Wake now. You'll feel better. I promise.
I had a wild dream last night. This beautiful entity came to me, promised to protect me, told me the parasite in our heads could give us power. Sounds like it. What did you make of it? Damn right. Things like a splinter. We just need to find a way to squeeze it out.
Feeling better.
Did you have any strange dreams of late? Vivid ones. Damn. I was hoping my imagination had gotten the better of me. But this must be something more. This dream companion wanted me to use the tadpole, use its power. Whoever it was claimed to be an ally, but I don't know. It seems like we can't escape this mess, in the waking world or otherwise.